Now, we are going to discuss about the chapter, the Union Legislature. In this chapter, Union Legislature, we are going to first discuss about the structure of Union Legislature. I mean, the Parliament of Indian Government. So, this chapter is classified into two parts. That is, first we will be discussing about the Union Legislature, I mean, the structure of Union Legislature, and then we will be discussing about the function of Union Legislature. You all know that India has multiple levels of government. Local self-government at the grassroots level, and the state government at the intermediate level, and the union government or central government at the topmost level. So the structure of a union government is, we have three structures, that is legislature, executive, and judiciary, which forms the central government of India. And all these three structures keep going hand by hand. What is the role of executives? What is the role of legislature and what is the role of judiciary? So the role of legislature, I mean the parliament is to make laws, and the executive has to implement the laws that are made by the legislature, and judiciary is always having a look on the laws made by the legislature and how the executives are implementing the laws. It means they help in solving the conflicts between the executive and legislature. So, as I told you earlier, the Union government consists of three organs, that is legislative, executive, and judiciary. This parliament is the central legislative organ of our government. It is the legislative organ of the Union government, which occupies the preeminent and central position in the democratic political system of India. You all know that India adopted the form of government. So, in this Union legislature, there are three parts, there are three houses, it means Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and President are the three parts of Parliament of India. You all know that Rajya Sabha, it means the Council of States or the House of Elders, Lok Sabha, the House of the People, and from where does this President come? You all know the President is not a member of either house of the Parliament, and he does not sit in the proceedings of the Parliament, but even though he is an integral of the Parliament. Why? The reason is he performs certain functions relating to the proceedings of the parliament. For example, he summons and prorogues the houses, dissolves the Lok Sabha, and issues ordinances when they are not in session. But the most important thing is that the bill which have been passed in both houses of the parliament cannot become a law without the president assent. That is why we always say the president is a part of a parliament. Now, we are going to discuss about the Rajya Sabha. We will be discussing about the composition of Rajya Sabha, I mean the strength, the election process, duration, and qualification and disqualification of members of Rajya Sabha. So first, Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the parliament. You all know that the members of the Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected by the members of legislative assemblies of each state. So therefore, we say this Rajya Sabha is a council of states. And this Rajya Sabha represents states and union territories of the Indian Union. So the Rajya Sabha consists of maximum strength of 250 members, amongst which 238 members are representatives of state and union territories who have been elected indirectly by the state legislative members. And 12 are the nominated by the president. But at present in Rajya Sabha, we have 245 members, amongst which 229 members represent the states and 4 represent the union territories, and 12 are the people who are nominated by the president. Now, my dear students, I told you that Rajya Sabha, the members of Rajya Sabha are elected indirectly. Yes, absolutely. Those members in Rajya Sabha are elected indirectly by the members of the state legislative assemblies, whom we elect directly and send to the state as a legislative representative of our constituencies. It is how the member of Rajya Sabha are being elected in states and also in union territories. So I told you that there are 12 members who have been elected by the president. On what basis they have been elected by the president is that the president nominates 12 to the Rajya Sabha from the people who have special knowledge or practical experience in art, literature, science, and social services. He nominates 12 persons. And you see, what is the term of Rajya Sabha? You all know that Rajya Sabha is a permanent house which is not subject to the dissolution, because every 2 years, 1/3 of the members retire from the houses, and two-third remains in the house. That is why we say that Rajya Sabha is a permanent house or a permanent body and a continuing chamber. The constitution has not fixed the term of the Rajya Sabha and left it to the parliament. Accordingly, the Parliament Act of 1951 has termed the office of member of Rajya Sabha shall be 6 years and one-third members will retire every 2 years. And they can be elected for any number of times and they can re-nominate for any number of times. And the eligibility criteria to become the member of Rajya Sabha is that they must be the citizen of India, number one, and they must not be less than 30 years of age, and he or she must possess qualification prescribed by the parliament. So for disqualification, if he is found guilty of certain election offences or corrupt practices in the election, or if he has been convicted for any offence resulting in imprisonment for 2 or more years, and if he holds office of a profit under the union or state government, he will be disqualified from the members of Rajya Sabha. And the presiding officer of Rajya Sabha, each house of parliament has its own presiding officer. There is a chairman and deputy chairman in Rajya Sabha. The presiding officer of Rajya Sabha is the vice president of India, and he is also the ex-official chairman of Rajya Sabha. And deputy chairman is selected by the members of Rajya Sabha among themselves, and he presides over the proceedings when chairman is absent. So now we will be discussing about the Lok Sabha. Here we will be discussing about the composition, I mean the strength of Lok Sabha, the election process, how they have been elected to the Lok Sabha, the term and the qualification and disqualification of members of Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha. So you all know that Lok Sabha is the lower house of the parliament, and you all know that it is the first chamber of the house of the people. The reason why we say it is house of the people is that the representatives or the members in the parliament of Lok Sabha are those who have been elected directly by the people of India. Therefore, the parliament, Lok Sabha, the members of Lok Sabha represents the people of India as the whole. The maximum strength of Rajya Sabha is 552. Out of these, 530 are to be representatives of the state and 20 are to be representatives of the union territories. Among these 9 union territories at present, 2 union territories, that is Delhi and Pondicherry, has the state legislative assembly, and from there the members of a parliament are being elected. They are elected very directly. And 2 members are to be nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. But at present, we have only 545 members, among which 530 members represent state and union territories, and 2 are nominated by the president from the Anglo-Indian community. So election to the Lok Sabha, as I told you earlier, they are elected directly by the people based on the principle of universal adult franchise. That is, those whoever are not less than 18 years can cast their vote and they can select their representatives from their particular constituencies. This is how they are elected directly from the states and union territories to the Lok Sabha to parliament. So the nominated members who are Anglo-Indian community, it means they are the people, European peoples who settled here from the ancestors. The president nominates 2 members of Anglo-Indian community if he or she thinks that Anglo-Indian community is not adequately represented in the Lok Sabha. When you are concerned about the term of Lok Sabha, you all know that it is not a continuing chamber because the Lok Sabha dissolves every 5 years. Therefore, its term is 5 years from the date of its first meeting. But at the same time, if a president can dissolve the Lok Sabha if no confidence motion passes over the Lok Sabha and if every council of ministers loses their confidence. When we speak about eligibility, the first criteria is that they must be the citizen of India and must not be less than 25 years of age. But in case of Rajya Sabha, they must not be less than 30 years of age. And he must possess other qualifications that have been prescribed by the parliament. And again, if he is found guilty of any election offences, or if he has been convicted for any offence resulting in imprisonment for more than 2 years, or if he holds any office under the profit of union or state government, he or she will be disqualified of Lok Sabha. So as like Rajya Sabha, the Lok Sabha also has the presiding officer, So there is a speaker to preside over the function of Lok Sabha, and the deputy speaker will preside over the function when during the absence of the speaker of Lok Sabha. So the speaker of Lok Sabha is the proceeding officer, and the speaker is elected by the Lok Sabha members amongst themselves after the first meeting. And after the first meeting, they do elect the deputy speaker. The deputy speaker is also elected among the members, but he is elected after the election of a speaker has